Okay, let's talk about the three steps to doing a bank reconciliation. The first step is to identify deposits in transits. That's a book thing. I'm sorry, bank side. Identify outstanding checks and any related errors. And then third, identifying any other reconciliation items that I need. So these are the three steps we're going to do. So I also need to compare my bank statement with last month's. If I had a deposit in transit last month, I need to make sure that it's already in the bank for this month. So any deposits not listed in the accounting records, I need to make sure they're in there. So here's our step one. We found a deposit dated November 21st that the bank had not received, but I already put it in my books. So I'm going to add it to, oops, sorry, I didn't mean to go past that. I'm going to add it to my bank side. So a deposit in transit is always added to the bank side. Well, next we're going to look at canceled checks. Any checks or any errors in regards to that. And I found one. So this check, I wrote it for $18.98. But when I put it on the bank stub, I accidentally wrote it for $19.88. This was $18.98, $19.88. Now this is not a check outstanding. It is an error in a check. I wrote the check for $18.98, and that's what I should have subtracted from my check stub, but I accidentally subtracted $19.88. So to fix the problem, I take the difference of 90 cents, and because I subtracted 1988 when I should have subtracted 1898, I'm going to add the 90 cents back to my book side. So an error on a check is always a book side. Okay. Next, we have canceled checks, and we're going to look at them and outstanding checks. Okay, and so here I found three checks. Here are my check numbers. Here are the amounts. I wrote the checks out. I paid somebody, but they have not cashed them. So I've already subtracted them from my book side. They need to be subtracted from the bank side up here. Okay, so notice I have bank side, add, subtract, adjusted, book side, add, subtract, adjusted. And finally, I want to look at anything else that was left off, whether it goes to the bank or to the book side. Well, I remember that I used an ATM machine to withdraw $100, but I didn't write it down in my books, but it's on my bank statement. So I'm going to subtract it from here. I'm going to subtract it from my book because the bank already took it out of my account. And then I found that one of my customers wrote me a check that bounced, an NSF check. Okay, well, the bank already took the money back, so I'm going to need to deduct it from down here. Okay, an NSF check always goes under the deduct side under the book balance. And I think we have one more mistake. The bank took out $1.80 for service charges. So the bank already took it out, but I didn't take it out of my books. And so now I'm doing that. So now we're ready to total. We're going to start with the bank side. We're going to add these two numbers. We're going to add up all my checks. It equals that. We're going to subtract them. And here's my adjusted bank side. So this is my adjusted bank balance. So now we'll do the bottom half of the sheet. I'm going to add these things here, which equal this. I'm going to add up these three items, which equals this, but I'm going to subtract them from up here, and here's what I get. So my actual bank rec form is now balanced. This equals this. But listen, just because it's balanced, nothing has been changed until I do a journal entry. Okay? I need journal entries to make, this is what my general ledger says, but I need it to say this. Okay, and before we start the journal entries, we're going to do that on the next video.